Does your family's water smell like bleach? That's chlorine. Is that chlorine causing skin irritations and rashes? How does your coffee and your tea taste when it's made with that water? Are your pets drinking that water? That can't be good. Why is chlorine being added to your municipal water anyway? In this video, I'm going to show you the cheapest and the best way to get rid of that chlorine for your family starting right now. Hi, I'm Gary the Water Guy, and I simplify water filtration to help you conquer crappy water for your family. If you want to learn how to remove the chlorine from your family's water, this video is for you. There's a number of ways that chlorine can be removed, and I'll be discussing the pros and the cons of each one. By the end of this video, you'll know which one is best for your family, and I definitely encourage you to watch this video right to the end, because I've got some tips that'll save your family hundreds of dollars while removing the chlorine from your water. Your city or municipality needs to make sure that the water being delivered to your home is bacteria-free. Now, you have to realize that water passes through miles and miles of pipes, some of it 100 years old or older, and the only way they can make sure that water that's actually getting to your home is bacteria-free is they have to add a disinfectant, and chlorine is a very popular disinfectant to be added. So chlorine kills the organisms and bacteria that's in the water, but it's definitely not something that you want family to be ingesting on a continual basis. Also, did you know that chlorine will significantly shorten the life of your water softener? We need to get rid of that chlorine before it gets into your home. Chlorine is toxic not only for microorganisms, but for humans too. For humans, it's an irritant for the skin and for your eyes. You shouldn't be inhaling those fumes. It's very hard on your lungs. It can cause all kinds of other health-related issues. In drinking water, the concentration of chlorine is quite low. But where the concern comes in is year after year, long-term use of constantly ingesting chlorinated water may be a long-term risk of cancer. The other concern are trihalomethanes and other disinfection byproducts as a result of chlorination. Trihalomethanes are carcinogens, and they've definitely been linked to the risk of colon, bladder, and rectal cancer. Now, Health Canada's Laboratory Centre for Disease Control says the benefits of chlorination far outweigh the risks, and that's why municipalities continue to chlorinate. It should be noted that in Europe, many communities have stopped chlorinating their water. So the good news is that chlorine can be oxidized out of your water. In other words, if you expose your water to air and give it a period of time, the air will oxidize the chlorine out of the water. So the cheapest and the simplest way to do that is just grab a simple bowl, fill it up with water, and set it aside for a couple hours, and the air will oxidize that chlorine out of your water. Now that's a great way of getting rid of the chlorine out of your water for watering your plants or for giving to your pets. Obviously, for a whole house solution, that isn't going to work too well. But you certainly can't beat the price. So another way of removing the chlorine is by going with a carbon filter, something like this. So this is just a small filter. So this will only give you about 1,000 gallons of capacity, and it's only good for 1 gallon per minute flow rate. So it definitely isn't a whole house solution. So this would be installed. It would be installed at a filter housing that would maybe just feed the cold water line that's going to your kitchen sink. And that way you can use that water that where the chlorine has been removed by the filter for, again, watering your plants, for giving to your pets, but also your drinking water for your family. You can use that water and freeze it to make ice cubes. And again, fairly low-cost solution. Hey, but can't you get larger filters to do the same thing and hook that up for the whole house? Absolutely. You can go with a filter like this. So this is a 20-inch big blue carbon filter. And again, you can put a filter housing and connect it up to the plumbing in your house, and the water flows through it. The only problem is, although the initial cost of that isn't all that high, but the ongoing cost is, because what happens is the chlorine gets captured inside that carbon filter and it accumulates in there. So what happens is, for a family of four, after a couple months of use, that filter will be totally saturated with chlorine and it's not going to remove your chlorine anymore. So now you have to replace that filter. So the cost on an ongoing basis definitely will accumulate very, very quickly. So another way that you can remove the chlorine from your family's water is with a reverse osmosis drinking water system like this Hume Water Saver 75. It'll not only remove all the chlorine, it'll remove a lot of other impurities from your water. So if you're just looking for a drinking water solution, this is a great one. So the best whole house solution for most families is an automatic backwashing filter like this Hume carbon filter. The beauty of the system is there's no chemicals to add, there's no filters to change, it just continually keeps doing its job, and it does it on the whole house. So it gets installed before the water softener as the water flows into the home, and then the water just flows through. The carbon inside traps that chlorine inside the filter, and then after about 5 days of use, it backwashes to clean itself out. Now at this point too, I should mention, this will only work on chlorine. It won't work on chloramines. So what are chloramines? It's basically when a municipality mixes ammonia and chlorine as a disinfectant. So the best way to know what your municipality uses is contact the water department and ask, do they use chlorine or do they use chlorine and ammonia to make chloramines? And if you do have chloramines in your water, I've got a great YouTube video that shows you how to remove those chloramines for your family. I'll put a link in the description down below. So these automatic backwashing filters are a great alternative to having to replace those large carbon filters month after month, year after year, and in the long run, much lower cost. And if you're interested about learning more about the specifics on how these systems actually work, again, I've got a great YouTube video that explains the whole process. I'll put a link in the description down below. And if you're wondering where you can go for more information on these Hume automatic backwashing carbon filters, you can check out our websites, either watereStore.com in the USA or watereStore.ca in Canada. We offer free shipping and discount pricing. So what's the best solution for removing the chlorine from the water for your family? Well, if you've got zero budget, you can always pour your water into a bowl, let it aerate, and use that for your pets. And like I say, for your watering your plants, you might want to use it for drinking water too. You have to check that out to see if that's suitable for your family or not. The cartridge filter will give you more flexibility and will also give you a better solution if it's running to, let's say, the cold water at the kitchen cold faucet, and you're using that for your drinking water, for your pets, for watering your plants. And a reverse osmosis system like this one here is a great solution if you're looking at removing the chlorine, but also a whole bunch of other contaminants that may be in your water. But again, it's a drinking water only solution. If you're looking for a budget whole house solution, the 20-inch Big Blue cartridge filter is definitely the way to go. Just keep in mind that although the initial cost is fairly low, the ongoing cost of having to constantly replace that filter will definitely add up. But if you're looking for a whole house solution, the Hume automatic backwashing carbon filter is definitely the best way to go. Keep in mind too, that chlorine will ruin your water softener. So by installing an automatic backwashing filter before that water softener, it'll save your family hundreds of dollars by not having to replace it. Click here for my next video on automatic backwashing filters, and I'll see you there.